Yeah, thank you for the opportunity to present my results. And before I start, a quick background. I did my studies, PhD, and a two-year postdoc in Germany before I decided I needed a change of scenery and move to Australia for another postdoc. So I work at CSIRO in rabbit biocontrol. And as you probably all know, rabbits are a pet species in Australia and cause a lot of damage. And rabbit haemorrhagic disease virus, or short RHDV, is used as a biocontrol. And it's very effective because it kills rabbit in 24 to 72 hours. But what if rabbits develop resistance, or the virus in the future the virus isn't as effective anymore? So I was on the search for possibly new biocontrol agents. And I had two different pathways. So one, get Australian rabbit samples from domestic rabbits where we have a bit of a clinical history, so we actually know that rabbit was sick. And trying to get international collaborations to get the national lagomorph samples. And one pathway for that is North American lagomorphs, which are different species, so it's not the European rabbit we have in Australia. And some of them were found dead but negative during an IHDV outbreak. Others were healthy ones from a large tissue collection. And the other international samples are collaborations with South America, more specifically Chile, where they have kind of the same problem with European rabbits. So what I did was first sequence 48 Australian rabbit samples, all that animals that were sent for us, to us for testing. They were RHDV negative, but had some clinical history with sudden deaths. So we were hoping maybe one of them has some interesting pathogens. And what I found was, in some animals, not all of them, hepatitis E virus, which is known to infect rabbits, but wasn't known to be in rabbits in Australia. Belongs to the family Hepaviridae, genus Orthohepivirus, species Orthohepivirus A. It's a single-stranded positive sense RNA virus with length about 7.2 kb. It's about the same as RHDV. It has eight genotypes, and the rabbit hepatitis E virus belongs to genotype 3. And it can also infect humans, and actually causes quite a lot of infections per year in the human population. And because it can infect humans and animals, it is considered being zoonotic. And there actually have been reports of people being infected with the rabbit hepatitis E strain. So I did a screened all our samples, trying to figure out how many positive hepatitis E rabbits we actually have. And yeah, you can see each red dot is a positive sample. Each green spot is a positive sample where I could also get the genetic information. And in addition to that, I also screened 11 different rabbit populations for the presence of hepatitis E antibodies. And it varies quite a lot. So you can see the places where I couldn't detect any antibodies at all, and then where it's almost a quarter of positive samples. And it's all around Australia, so it's not just one localized spot where you can find hepatitis E virus. It's all over the place. Like I said, I also did sequencing, and I found that the genetic range for hepatitis E virus is quite broad. So that varies about 85 to 99% identity. And as you can see with all the different lines, there isn't any geographic clustering. So the virus is all over the place. But I have to say all these samples are from domestic rabbits. So this is probably just a display like also how much rabbits are transported and traded around Australia. I also did a comparison with sequences that are available worldwide from hepatitis E in rabbits. Unfortunately, that is not a lot. And I tried to date back when the virus might have arrived in Australia. But you can see with the large blue lines, the error rate is quite broad. So it's really hard to say. But based how they cluster with international sequences, it's kind of sure to say it was introduced more than once. I detected other pathogens, and I won't go more into detail for this figure. I just wanted to show how complex the studies are and how complex you can make a figure if you want to. Yeah, if you want to have more detail, have a look at the publications already published. But what other pathogens did I find? So I found several Clostridia species that might or might not be pathogenic. One of them was Clostridia perfringens, which is cause for food poisoning. I found Pastorella, which is known to infect and kill rabbits. Also Coccidia, which is a known pathogen. Pseudomonas and yeast. We know, like say, for some of them, they can cause disease. For others, they might just be commensal pathogens or opportunistic microbes because the rabbit is already sick. Unfortunately, nothing that really works as a new biocontrol, because with hepatitis E, I haven't said that before, it makes the rabbit sick, but it doesn't kill the rabbit. So yeah, and it can infect humans, so we don't want that around. What have I done since then? So I switched from postdoc position to a research project officer, and started on my international search for new biocontrol agents. I have collaborations with the Texas Tech University and the National Wildlife Health Center in Wisconsin to investigate North American native lagomorphs. Those are Sylvilagus and Lepus species. So they are related to rabbits, but yeah, still quite distinct. And then the collaborations with partners in Chile to investigate their European rabbit samples, and I hope they will finally get here in the next few weeks. And I already have some interesting findings, but unfortunately still no silver bullet. And yeah, has been a huge team who helped with all the work. And yeah, thank you for listening.